Hello friends! Hey, on October 4th, a new film is hitting a B&B theater screen near you from Warner Brothers called Joker. I'm excited about this movie. I love the character. I love Joaquin Phoenix. I'm going to love this movie. So we thought we'd make a little video to talk a little bit about the upcoming film, the significance, the enduring legacy of this character, the cultural impact of the Joker as one of the most complex and reinvented villains in pop culture. Personal favorite of mine. But the question remains, who is he? And where did he come from? So let's dive in. Now, we've never seen an honest-to-goodness origin story on screen, and we'll talk about that here in a few seconds, as well as the other cinematic iterations of the character. But let's talk about his true origin, where we first met him, in the pages of the comics. The Joker debuted in DC Comics Batman number 1 on April 25th of 1940, but even his real-world creation is disputed, with both Bob Kane and Jerry Robinson claiming responsibility for the Joker's design, which was inspired by Conrad Veidt's truly unsettling performance as Gwynplaine in 1928's The Man Who Laughs. Now, the Joker was intended to be killed off in that very first Batman book, but editorial intervention spared him, and Batman's archenemy and perfect adversary was born. Now, throughout the decades, the comic iteration of the Joker has been portrayed as a mastermind, as a psychopath, as like a goofy prankster, criminal folk hero, and a sadistic torturer and murderer. And he has been written and inked by virtually all of the legends of the business, from Alan Moore to Alex Ross to Frank Miller to Paul Dini to Jim Lee. The comics have hinted at origin stories for the Joker, but definitive history remains a little vague, to say the least. Even the Joker himself is an unreliable narrator who seems uncertain himself of who he was before and how he became the Joker, stating in Detective Comics 168, "Sometimes I remember it one way, sometimes another." The Joker has claimed a number of origins, including being the child of an abusive father who broke his nose and the long-lived jester of an Egyptian pharaoh. As Batman says, like any other comedian, he uses whatever material will work. Now, the most common interpretation of the Joker's origin involves the Red Hood storyline, which dates back to 1951. And in that story, the character begins as a simple criminal who, during his final heist, vanishes after leaping into a vat of chemicals to escape the Batman. His resulting disfigurement left him to adopt the name Joker from the playing card figure he came to resemble. This story was all but canonized in 1988 with the release of Batman: The Killing Joke, the same year the Joker committed the infamous Death in the Family, in which he beats Jason Todd with a crowbar and leaves him for dead. Okay, so there's a nutshell version of the Joker from the books, but what of the on-screen Joker, or Jokers? Well, the character's earliest on-screen adaptation was in the 1966 Adam West television series, Batman. Bam! Bam! And its film adaptation, Batman. Now, in this famously campy production, the Joker was a silly and cackling prankster played by Cesar Romero. And the Joker then continued to appear in some animated television adaptations throughout the 70s and 80s, being voiced at one time by the legendary Frank Welker. But a darker version of the Joker made his film debut in 1989's Batman, which earned over $400 million at the worldwide box office. While few can deny the impact of Michael Keaton on the public perception of the Caped Crusader, the Joker role was a defining performance for Jack Nicholson, and it is generally accepted that he stole the show. His character in the film, Jack Napier, falls into the vat of chemicals we've discussed previously, but also happened to be the crook who shot Thomas and Martha Wayne, a variation unique to this 1989 production. Now, that film's success led to the 1992 television series, Batman the Animated Series, which introduced audiences to the now iconic Joker voice talent of Mark Hamill. But despite the fact that the stories were designed for younger audiences, Hamill retained the darker tone of the comics, and his performance became definitive. He continued to voice the character in spin-off films like 1993's Batman: Mask of the Phantasm and 2000's Batman Beyond: Return of the Joker. Also in some video games like the Arkham series, for example, and some other related properties. Now, he voiced the character cinematically in 2016's animated theatrical release of The Killing Joke. Fast forward, however, to Christopher Nolan's successful 2005 Batman film reboot, Batman Begins. You might recall that film ended with a Joker teaser, and the character appeared in 2008's The Dark Knight, played by Heath Ledger. This interpretation was one of anarchy and chaos, and the character misled Gothamites and audiences with varied and increasingly traumatic explanations of how he got these scars, leaving us all to guess as to who the Joker is, who he was, how he came to be. Fan theories abound. Ledger's performance earned him a posthumous Academy Award. Batman Begins earned a worldwide total of $370 million. The Dark Knight, however, earned over $1 billion and was the highest grossing film of the year, setting several additional records, you know, in the process. Now, there were lots of Joker iterations on the small screen between Ledger's iconic portrayal and the next cinematic debut, but time is short, so let's keep moving. In 2016, Jared Leto portrayed the Joker in Suicide Squad. Following the hugely popular performance by Ledger, Leto had some big clown shoes to fill. Ultimately, an abrasive, unhinged, and aggressive tone was struck and the brutal and urban Joker emerged. This also marked the first time Joker was paired cinematically with his off-and-on love interest, Harley Quinn. Incidentally, Zach Galifianakis voiced the character in 2017's Lego Batman movie, if anyone is keeping track. Now then, in August of 2017, Warner Brothers revealed plans for a standalone film based on the Joker, directed by Todd Phillips. That film, simply called Joker, comes out October 4th. And in it, Joaquin Phoenix plays the famed clown Prince of Crime in a gritty, real-world interpretation, the first R-rated live-action portrayal of the character. This film promises to reinvent the origin story yet again, this time taking an unflinching look at the impact of psychological trauma. All right, there it is, guys. The Joker recap. We did it. Hey, who's your favorite Joker? Let us know in the comments. I could probably make a case for all of them. I enjoy them all in their own way. And I'm excited for this one on October 4th, Joaquin Phoenix and Warner Brothers Joker. Be sure and check it out at a B&B Theatres location near you. Tickets and showtimes available online at bbtheatres.com. Thank you, my friends, and enjoy the magic of the movies.